गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ डेटा वेयर हाउसिंग. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द डेटा माइनिंग टेक्निक्स. सो डेटा वेयर हाउसिंग इज कंसिडर्ड एज अ पार्ट ऑफ डेटा माइनिंग टेक्निक्स. वेयर हाउस मीन्स वेयर वी आर स्टोरिंग आवर डेटा सेट. वेयर हाउस इज अ कॉमन वर्ड. ओके, वेयर यू कैन से वेयर हाउस मे बी कंसिडर्ड एज अ प्लेस वेयर वी कैन स्टोर आवर थिंग्स, आवर डिफरेंट प्रोडक्ट्स. So data warehousing is a process, it's a way in which we store our entire database into a single place, into a single platform. So this process is known as data warehousing. Okay, so this is the content of today's lecture. We will start with some definitions and types, the components of data warehouse, what is the architecture of data warehouse, database designing, OLAP and metadata disposal. Okay, so OLTP already discussed in the previous classes, online transactional protocol. Okay, online transaction protocol, whatever the transaction we do online, it is known as OLTP. Okay, whereas when we talk about warehousing, it's organization of the data sets for a particular topic on a particular type. So in the data mining technique, generally when we talk about data mining, in data mining we use OLTP technique. OLTP is an online transaction protocol. Whatever the data we are using, whatever the transactions we are doing, we are using it online, without any manual processing. Whereas warehousing is a process where we store all the data sets. It is organized by the particular subject. Depending on your requirement, you can select any of the data set and you can store it in a platform or in any online platform, or you can store it offline. Okay, so OLTP is a online transaction protocol. So definitely the entire data set is available online, so it may have multiple number of users, many number of users in comparison to the very few number of users for warehousing. Okay, and in OLTP we are having access for few records, warehousing having entire table. We can access of the entire data set, and OLTP is a smaller database and warehouse is having large database, because warehousing means we are collecting the entire data set, we are collecting the entire database into a single platform, so definitely it will have a large number of data sets. Whereas OLTP having a smaller data sets, because we are processing it online, so we only use the data which is required for such processing. Okay, and OLTP is on normalized data structure, whereas warehousing is unnormalized, and it's a continuous updation for the OLTP and warehousing having periodic update. Obviously when we are using online database, so it will be continuously updating, like your software, your Microsoft Office, your Windows, it's continuously updating because it is connected to the online. But if your database is not connected online, it's a kind of storage of your database. You may have the offline storage of your database, so you may manually update your database. It will be the periodic update of your database. So warehousing means, simply when we talk about warehouse means where we are storing our database, where we are managing, where we are collecting entire data set, that is known as warehouse. Okay, warehouse is a word that may be used in your real world, in real time it may be used, where you can store your products, like you can store your laptops in storeroom, you can store your mobiles, you can store your any food products in a godown, you call it as a godown. Okay, in daily life you may have the word godown. Godown is a place where you store the entire products. So in the same way, warehouse is a place, warehouse is a location or directory, or you can say it's a repository where you are storing the entire database, that is known as warehouse. So the data warehouse is a subject oriented integrated time variant and non volatile collection of the data in the support of management of decision making process. Okay, it's an integrated approach, means it's not like that you are storing a same kind of database. You may have multiple types of data sets. You can store any types of database into a single platform that is known as data warehouse, and that database can be used for the management of decision making process. It is the process whereby the organizations extract values from their informational assets through use of special stores called the data warehouse. Okay, it's organization of your database. Whatever the database you are having, how you are organizing your database, and on demand, how you are extracting some useful information from your data warehouse. It is very important in database management system. So data warehouse may be of three types. Operational data store, that may have some operational data measure, that is how many data sets or how many items in the stock. Then enterprise data warehouse, it is having historical analysis, and it is very complex. And data mart, they said data mart means you have heard the word V mart, D mart. Okay, mart means it's a kind of shortest form of market. Data mart means data market, or you can say where you are have stored your data, and anyone can access your database, that is data mart. So data warehousing having three types: operational data store, enterprise data warehouse, and data mart. So what are the uses of the data warehouse? How it is important? So it's a presentation of the standard reports and graphs. Okay, suppose you are having database, and someone wants to know that how much data set you are having, and how many types of data sets you are having. So you can represent your database in the form of some report and graphs, and it may be used for dimensional analysis and data mining. Dimensional analysis, you can say that anyone can analyze that how many types of data sets are available and what is the storage capacity of your database, how many products or how many types of data is available in your data warehouse, and that will be used as data mining. Data mining is extraction of useful information from your database. So your data is stored in the form of data warehouse. It's a large amount of database, and from large amount of database, whatever we are going to extract and what is the useful information which we can extract from that data warehouse is done using the data mining techniques. Data mining is the extraction of useful information from your stored database. That database is stored in a place which is known as data warehouse. Okay, so advantages of data warehousing is it is having lower cost of information access, it improves the customer responsiveness, and it can identify the hidden business opportunities and strategic decision making. Okay, it is very cost effective, means you can store your database in the data warehouse, that will lower your cost, and it will be useful for the information extraction. It will improve the customer response. It can identify the hidden business opportunities, and you can use this data warehouse for making any decision, for any strategic decision making. Okay, so what are the roadmap? What is the process to the development of data warehouse? What are the process through which we can produce or we can construct our data warehouse? So it is data extracted, transformed, and cleaned. It may be stored in the database. Your database may be stored in the form of relational database management system or multiple database management system. You can also having the option for query and reporting system, and it can execute the information system and the decision support system. So this is the roadmap to the data warehousing. This roadmap is very important, and whenever we are going to construct or whenever we are going to develop a data warehousing, so we need to work on the storage of our database. The database can be stored in the form of relational database management system, which is very well known as a relational table. And data warehousing also provides you the facility for query processing. You can extract some useful information by some query, and you can execute information system and decision support system for that data warehousing. Data extraction and the load. So how we are going to extract the data from the data warehouse? So we need to first find the source of the data. Means what kind of data sets are there, whether it is in the form of table or in the form of files, in form of any document or any kind of email or internet. You need to first identify the source of data. data may be any type. Data may be of any type. It may be in the form of tables. It may be in form of different files. It may be in the form of different documents. It may be in the form of emails or internet data sets. Bad data quality, then you need to identify the bad quality data sets that may have the same name but different things, different units. That will reduce the data redundancy. If you have stored the data, multiple data sets of the same type with multiple name, same data set is stored with multiple names, so it will be considered as the data redundancy, the duplication of the data sets. So you can identify the bad quality of the data sets and you can have the option to reduce the data redundancy. Then there are different tools to clean the data set that is known as Apertus. Apertus is a tool. It's a tool that is used for cleaning your database. Cleaning means it will identify the bad quality of the data sets and it will identify the data redundancy and it will clean the bad quality data sets and data redundancy. And these are the tools to convert the codes, to aggregate and to calculate the derived values. And data re-engineering tool is also there to reconstruct your database. Okay, so moving to the next slide. So metadata, as we all know that metadata is the data about data. Whatever the data you are having, the properties and qualities of your database is considered as metadata. Okay, metadata is the database that describes the various aspects of the data in the warehouse. If you are having different databases in the warehouse, so what kind of database is there? Who is the owner of that database? What are the properties of that database? This information is known as metadata. So we can say that metadata is the data about data. Then administrative metadata, having some source database and it contains the transformation required, history of the migrated data. The end user metadata. Metadata may be of two types: administrative metadata and end user metadata. The administrative metadata includes the source database, means under administrative metadata, we will have the information about the source of your data, what is the content of that data, and what is the history of that data, from where you have extracted, from where you have gained, you have retrieved that database. Then end user metadata defines the warehouse data and description of your database and the consolidated hierarchy. So metadata is very important. It will tell you the source of your database, quality of your database, history of your database, and what is the description of your database. The entire information about your database is known as metadata. Okay. Storage. Storage means how you are going to store your data in data warehouse. So generally, we use relational database management system, or you can call it as a table, relational table. Entire database are stored in the form of relational tables, and which is also known as relational database management system. Okay. MDD, multiple database. Multiple database is the measurement or the number that quantify the business process, and it is the dimensions that are attributed that describe the measurement. So what is the, how many number of databases are available, what is the attribute of your database, and how you are going to describe the measurements of your database, that is known as multi metadata. Okay, MDD, multi database or multi metadata, you can say. The information analysis and delivery. Okay, so by using this data warehousing, it will speed up the retrieval of the database. You can retrieve database very quickly if you are having entire database stored in a single platform. So it will be easy to retrieve your database. It will be easy to retrieve your required database from your data warehouse. It also supports ad hoc query, like it will have different query and analytical functions. It will be used for managing the business layer between the user and database. And multidimensional online analytical processing. Online analytical processing means it supports the complex analysis of the dimensional data online. Whatever the data you are having, if you are going to process, if you are going to analyze your data set online, then this process is known as OLAP or online analytical processing. So it supports the complex analysis. If you are having the large number of data sets, then you can use OLAP for analyzing this complex data sets, this complex kind of data sets, which is stored in the form of relational table or relational database. Okay. So DSS, decision support system, already discussed with you that DSS is a process that helps you to make any decision, that will help you to make any decision process in case of large number of data sets. So it is a analytical function that will provide you the facility to support or to make any decision in case of you are getting confused with the large number of data sets. If you are having large number of data sets and you are not able to take any decision, so you can use decision support system that will provide you to make a decision on that, on the basis of that database. Okay. Managing the data warehouse. So how you are going to manage the data warehouse? Data warehouse is a large number of data sets. So have large storage capacity. It requires large storage capacity, but still with this large storage capacity, you need to work on the security, backup, and tracking. Okay. It's a large number of data sets. So definitely you are required or you should require a large storage capacity. You should have large storage of the database, but also there may be the good procedure for the security and backups. Security is important part of the data warehouse. So nobody can unauthorizedly access your database. You can prevent the unauthorized access to your database by having some security features. Backups are very important in case of data damage or data loss. You may have some options for the backup recovery of your data warehouse and tracking. You can have the facility to track the data continuously. So you may have the information that is there any update is required or is there any unauthorized access to your database. Okay. So the process of the management of data warehouse, it includes the monitoring of updates like change in the source, the quality of the data, and accurate and up to date. Okay. So management of the data warehouse, including the security, backup, tracking, as well as the continuous updation of your database. So it will be updated multiple times. So you will get good quality of data set and your data will be having good accuracy. You will have good accurate data sets. These are the tools. These are some, you can say these are the software or tools that may be used for the data warehousing. Okay, then you can have these tools, SAS, Aperture, Trillium, Oracle. Okay, these are some advanced tools, or you can say these are the softwares that can be used in the process of data warehousing. Like SAS, it's a software that will be used for the data extraction from your data warehouse. Data cleaning can be done using Aperture and Trillium. These are the tools and softwares that will identify the bad quality of the data sets, that will identify the data redundancy in your data warehouse, and it will work on the cleaning of your data set. Data storage can be done by Oracle and Sybase. These are the tools that will be used for storing your database. Means you need to have a large storage capacity. So Oracle and Sybase provides you the large storage capacity to store your data warehouse. Optimizers, having advanced parallel optimizer, bitmap indices, and star index. Okay. These are the tools that will be used for the development of your data warehouse. IBM Visualizer, Oracle, Relational OLAP, Informix, MetaCube. Okay. So these are some softwares and tools that will be used for the storing of your data warehouse, for the development of your data warehouse, or for the data storage and security of your data warehouse. Architecture. The architecture of data warehouse is a kind of moving to lower cost microprocessor, micro focus COBOL, lower cost, having no transparent access to the data set. So architecture is very simple, like it is stored in a simplest way by using Micro Focus COBOL. Micro Focus COBOL is a software, it's a tool that will be used for the architecture of your data warehouse. Okay, and mainframe server, you can also have the facility to store your data warehouse on the server. Server is a storage of the data that will having the facility to have large storage capacity. So you can have the option of using server to store your data warehouse or to store your databases in the form of data warehouse. Means you can store your data warehouse on a server. So it will have two-tier approach. When it is stored on the server, so it will be accessed by any user on request. If you allow any user to access your database, so he can easily access your database. There may be front-end client and backup end server. There may be Power Builder that may have front-end end tool, minimal investment in the extra hardware, data consistency, hidden fat client cannot be used if number of end users increases. Okay, this is the architecture. Okay, then there is another option of enterprise information architecture that is having three-tier process means there may be some end user, then there may be server, and there may be a third party user of your database. So the source data on the host computer will be based on the server like Oracle and MDD, and front end use like DSS and the EIS. So this is the architecture of your data warehouse. It will be two-tier or three-tier. Two-tier means there will be only the client and server. But when we talk about three-tier architecture, it will be client, server, and the middleware that is having some source on the host computer. That's a kind of database server like Oracle. RDBMS is very well known to you, Relational Database Management System. The entire data is stored in the form of Relational Database Management System. It provides the quick response to the queries. If someone asks something, if someone wants to retrieve some information from your database, so Relational Database Management System provides the rapid response to any of the query. Okay, for that we use bitmap index and the index structure. So functionality added to the conventional RDBMS like data extraction and the replication. So data extraction and replication means you can have the multiple copies of the same database. You can copy the same database multiple times. That is known as replication. If you are copying any Word file or PDF file, you can have multiple copies of the same Word file or PDF file. So it is known as replication. So Relational Database Management System provides us the facility for data extraction and the replication of the database. You can have the multiple copies of the same database using Relational Database Management System. Okay, MDD, multidimensional database. Multidimensional database is having decision support environment that supports the iterative queries. It is an extension to the SQL that is used for the high performance data warehousing, and this performance degrades as size increases. So there is an inability to incrementally load. Loading is slow, so no agreed upon the model. Now moving to the next slide. There is no standard access method like SQL in the multidimensional database. There may be the minor changes required for complete the reorganization of your database. Data access tools. So for accessing the data, we are having different tools. We are having different data access tools like Esperant, DSS, EIS, that is Express, used by the financial specialist. Database designing should be simple. The data must be clean, and there may be the fast query processing in case of data warehousing, and there may be the fast loading. So these are the requirements for the designing of any database for data warehousing. It should be simple. the data must be clean, the query processing must be fast, and there may be the fast loading of your database. Star schema, it's a process, it consists of a group of tables that describes the dimensions of the business that may be arranged logically around the huge central table that contains all the accumulated facts and the figures of the business. So the smaller the outer table are points of the star, the larger table the center from which the point radiate. For a star schema, we should have some fact table, we should have some dimensional table, and we should have some summary. Under fact table, we are having the information about the cell, order, budget, and real values of the database that may be in the numeric form. The dimension table includes the period, time period, you can say the market, the product, and summary will be having the aggregate information from the fact table and the dimension table. So this is the star schema for data warehousing. Data you can trust, it may have referential integrity. There may be the query speed that may have fact table, primary key, dimension table that may have all columns, the query optimizer which understands the star schema, and the load processing must be done offline. And this issue if the aggregate data is stored. So during the star schema process, you can have the entire, you can have the multiple stages, data you can trust, then query speed and the load processing. The variation of the star schema. Star schema may have different variations that may be outboard tables, the fact table families, and the multi-star fact table. OLAP, online analytical processing. Okay. For OLAP, we should have front-end tool for multi-dimensional database. There may be slice report, then pivot report, alert reporting, time-based and exception reporting. So for OLAP, we should have these steps to be involved for any kind of processing related to the online analytical or online analytical processing of your database. Why OLAP? Like it's a process of generating the information as well as using it and storing this additional information by updating the data source. Whatever the data we are using, it should have some modeling capabilities that will be including a calculation engine for deriving the results and the creating the aggregations, consolidations, and the complex calculations. The forecasting, the trend analysis, the optimization, and the statistical analysis is a major component of using in case of using wide OLAP. When we are using wide OLAP, it should have forecasting, trend analysis, optimization, and the statistical analysis. Relational OLAP has a powerful SQL generator. It will be used to generate a optimized SQL for the largest or for the data space which you are targeting, and it is having rapidly changing dimensions. When we are using a relational database management system for OLAP, it is having rapidly changing database, and it is very powerful SQL generator that will be used for optimizing the target database. MDB, multi-dimensional database based OLAP, it is having row level calculations, it's having financial functions, the currency convergence, and interest calculations for that MDD OLAP. Metadata is should be user oriented. As we know that metadata is data about data. So it will have the definition of all the attributes of your database. It should be also system oriented, that will include the record and the field edit procedure of the database. These are the uses of databases. It should be used as a map source system data to the data warehouse table. It will be used to generate the extracted database, the transformation of your database, and the load procedure for the import jobs. It helps the users to recover what data are in the data warehouse, and it helps the user structure queries to assess the data they need. Describing the data warehouse. So the data warehouse description will be input output object that will have some file, that will have some database in the form of table, and it will have some relational relationship. The data element should be there, the name of the database, the definition, the type of the data. And now important is that you should have the role and participation of different constraints in case of a relationship function. And also we'll have field assignment for describing the data warehouse. Extract jobs for wholesale replace, wholesale append, update replace, and the update append. Data quality, like having the target and the actual quality characteristics. Planning for data warehousing should include the interviews, the data quality, the data access, timeless, and history, data sources, and the decision on the architecture of that data warehouse. So these are the developmental process for the data warehousing. The data warehousing process includes the project intimation, the development enterprise information, that is having architecture, design data warehouse database, transform the data, manage data, metadata, develop user interface, and manage the production. Evolution of data warehouse includes the support of the current data warehouse baseline. It will be used for the enhancing the current baseline capabilities, and how to define the new business requirements, and how we are implementing the new baseline for the data warehousing, or in the process of the development of data warehouse. These are some common mistakes or errors that may cause in the data warehousing. That will, and it will be starting with the wrong sponsorship chain. Then it will be setting the expectations that cannot be met, believing that data warehouse designing is the same as the transactional database design, believing the performance, the capacity promises, and also believing that once the data warehouse is up and running, problems are finished. These are the mistakes that are some common errors that may be caused during the development of data warehousing. Okay, so these are the new tools and techniques, Oracle or Unix, that will be used for the data warehousing, and IYM with alarms, and the INGRES. These are the Harris semiconductors. These are the tools and these are the hardware that can be used for the process of the data warehousing. So thank you very much for today's class, and we will meet again in the next class with the next lecture. Thank you very much.